Now we'll see few bits related to this, few other bits related to the same chapter. See, which of the following compounds on reaction with CH3MgBr, this is nothing but Grignard reagent, will give tertiary alcohol. Usually, tertiary alcohols are obtained by reacting ketone with Grignard reagent. Sometimes esters are also reacting with Grignard reagent, can give that type of product. Okay, among the all given options, this is the ester except formate. Okay, except formate, remaining all other esters undergoing reaction with Grignard reagent can give finally ketone as the final product. Okay, so the answer is second one. See the next question. 1 mole of ethyl acetate on treatment with excess of lithium aluminium hydride in dry ether and subsequent acidification produces what? That we want to find out. First write down whatever they have given in the question. So ethyl acetate, that is CH3COOC2H5. Ethyl acetate, CH3COOC2H5. Now it is undergoing reduction in presence of lithium aluminium hydride and in presence of dry ether. Okay, when these two undergo reduction process, exactly here bond involves in breakage. CH3CO converts into acid, that is CH3COOH. Acid is obtained plus C2H5O. Now here bond involves in breakage. C2H5O is added by hydrogen, we will get C2H5OH as the final product. That means one acetic acid and one ethyl alcohol is formed. So the answer is first one, 1 mole of acetic acid and 1 mole of ethyl alcohol is formed as the final product. Now see the next one, the mechanism of the reaction, that is acid catalyzed dehydration of alkene, involves three steps. We know acid catalyzed dehydration, acid catalyzed hydration of alkene involves three steps. First one, protonation of alkene to form carbocation. This is the first step, protonation of alkene to form carbocation. Second, nucleophilic attack of water to the carbocation. This is second step. And finally, what happens? Deprotonation of alcohol. This is the order. So first, second reaction will take place, next first one, next third one. So the answer is second one. 2, 1, and 3. This is the order of acid catalyzed hydration of alkene to alcohol. Okay, next, which statement is not correct about the alcohol? Okay, alcohols are lighter than water, that is correct only, and alcohol evaporates quickly, immediately, because they are containing, they are volatile in nature. Due to containing volatility, they can easily evaporate into the environment. Next, see the next one. Alcohol of less number of carbon atoms is less soluble in water. No, so lower number of alcohols are always soluble in most of the solvents. So this is the incorrect statement. Okay, among all. Next, dehydration of ethanol gives what? Dehydration of ethanol. Dehydration means what? Removal of water. Ethanol means CH3CH2OH. This is ethanol. Now it is undergoing dehydration in presence of concentrated H2SO4. Removal of water. Hydrogen from here, OH from here eliminates. CH3 converts to CH2. Double bond CH2, that is ethene. So this ethene is also known as ethylene. We can also call it as ethylene. So dehydration of ethanol can give ethylene as the product. Okay, next question. Alcohols of low molecular weight, okay, they are containing low molecular weight. Low molecular weight of alcohols are soluble in almost all of the solvents. So they are soluble in all solvents. Okay, next. Ethyl alcohol on oxidation with K2Cr2O7 gives what? Ethyl alcohol. Take ethyl alcohol, that is CH3CH2OH. Now it is undergoing oxidation. Okay, in presence of K2Cr2O7 as an oxidizing agent. Immediately, okay, here two hydrogens are eliminated, so it requires two oxygens, nascent oxygens. In that, one nascent oxygen react with H2 and eliminates as H2O. Now one more oxygen is there, that is added to this carbon, converts to CH3COOH. What is its name? It is known as acetic acid. That means oxidation of ethyl alcohol in presence of K2Cr2O7 always gives acetic acid. Answer is first one. Okay. Next, see the next question. The reaction between alcohol and acid with elimination of water is called what? Okay. Alcohol with acid. I am taking here ethyl alcohol C2H5OH plus acetic acid. Okay. I am taking in presence of acid, acetic acid. CH3COOH. Okay. Elimination of water should take place. OH from here, hydrogen from here eliminates. Now CH3COO part is added by C2H5. Then we will get CH3COOC2H5. Is it in the form of RCOOR? Okay. It is in the form of RCOOR, which is known as ester. Okay, the process of formation of ester by the removal of water from acid and alcohol is known as esterification reaction. So, reaction between alcohol and acid with the elimination of water is known as esterification reaction. That is the first option. Now, see the next bit. That is maximum solubility of alcohol in water. Okay, alcohols are soluble in water. This is due to making hydrogen bonds with the water. So alcohols are having the property to form hydrogen bond with the water, so they are soluble easily in the water. So the answer is third one. Next, when primary alcohol is oxidized with chlorine, okay, here primary alcohol is oxidizing with chlorine, it produces what? That we want to find out. I am taking here for primary alcohol example as ethyl alcohol, that is CH3CH2OH. This is primary alcohol because OH group containing carbon atom is attached with only one another carbon. Now it is undergoing oxidation in presence of chlorine, 2 moles of Cl2. Okay. This contains totally 4 chlorines. Among the 4 chlorines, 3 chlorines replaces these 3 hydrogen atoms. Then CCl3 we will get. Upon this carbon atom, 3 hydrogens are replaced by 3 chlorine atoms. Bond, one more chlorine is there, that replaces hydrogen from here. Okay, that replaces hydrogen from here, and we will get here CHO. That takes this hydrogen, eliminates as HCl. Okay, then we will get CHO. Only one H, two hydrogens are eliminated here, and we will get CHO. So finally, we got this product, that is CCl3CHO. Trichloroethanol is formed as the final product. So this is the answer, third one. Next, which of the following reagents cannot be used to oxidize primary alcohols to aldehyde? We want only aldehydes from the primary alcohol. This can be done by using chromium oxide, pyridinium chromochloride, or heating with the copper at 573 Kelvin's temperature. So when you use these three, completely primary alcohols are converted into aldehydes. If you use KMnO4 present in acidic medium, KMnO4 present in acidic medium, it can convert primary alcohols into aldehyde, which again on oxidation converts into acid. That means instead of aldehydes, here finally we will get acids as the final products. So if you want only aldehyde from the alcohols, we should not use this KMnO4 present in acidic medium. If we use what we will get? Instead of aldehydes, we will get finally acids as the final product. So that we should not use KMnO4 as an oxidizing agent, okay, for the conversion of primary alcohols into aldehydes. Clear? Now we'll see the next one. The acidic character of alcohols is due to, acidic character of alcohol is due to the, this is due to polar nature of OH bond. Okay, polar nature, because it is containing partial negative charge, it is with partial positive charge. Due to the polar nature of oxygen hydrogen bond, it can show acidic nature and loses hydrogen as a H+ ion. Next, see the next one. In the esterification reaction of alcohol, okay, in esterification what happens? OH is replaced by the CH3COO group. That's why we are getting esters as the final product. So answer is fourth one. Next one, order of esterification of alcohols. Which type of alcohols easily participates in esterification? Whatever the alcohol is with the simple groups, they can easily participate in esterification. Among all three types of alcohols, primary alcohol is containing simple group, so it can easily participate in esterification than secondary than tertiary. So this is the order. Okay, next, which of the following alcohols will give the most stable carbocation during dehydration? Okay, stable carbocation is always tertiary. Okay, tertiary carbocation is stable than secondary than primary. Understand? Among the four types, which will give the tertiary carbocation? Among all which is containing tertiary carbon, that we want to write. First write 2-methylpropanol. 2-methylpropanol. CH3, CH2, OH. This is 2-methylpropane-1-ol. This is first option. Next, second one, butanol, that is CH3, CH2, 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 OH. Next, third one, 2-methyl-2-propanol. 2-methyl-2-propanol. OH, CH3, CH3. This is parent chain. At second carbon, methyl group is there and OH group is also there. Next, fourth one, 2-butanol. I am writing the structure of 2-butanol. CH3, CH2, CH, OH, CH3. This is 2-butanol. Now, among the all which can give more stable carbocation, that we want to find out. Tertiary carbocation is more stable. Among all which can give this is the OH group. If it loses this OH, this is primary carbon. Why it is primary? Because it is attached with only one another carbon. The OH group is attached to this carbon. This is also primary because it is in turn attached with only one another carbon. Now OH is located on this carbon which attached with three other carbon, so it is containing tertiary carbon. Okay, now OH group is located on which carbon? Secondary carbon. Among the given options, which is containing tertiary carbon? This one, third one. What is the third one? 3-methyl-2-propanol. Okay, it can give the stable carbocation, that is tertiary carbocation. Understand? Now finally, last one, arrange the following alcohols in order of increasing. Okay, in order of increasing. They have given three types of alcohols. This is tertiary alcohol, this is secondary alcohol, and this is the primary alcohol. We want to arrange them in their reactivity towards the increasing reactivity towards the sodium metal. So always tertiary alcohols are more reactive towards the sodium metal. Sorry. Primary alcohols are always more reactive than the secondary, than the tertiary. Here they have given in this order. Okay, that means this is less reactive. Tertiary alcohols are less reactive than the secondary. Secondary are less reactive than the primary towards the sodium metal. Why tertiary alcohols are less reactive? Because of containing three bulky groups. Once the bulky groups number increases, the reactivity decreases. So the answer is third one. Okay, so that means primary alcohols are always more reactive than secondary than tertiary, or we can also say tertiary alcohols are less reactive than secondary, secondary are less reactive than the primary alcohols towards the sodium metal. So this is about today's class. Here I have explained few bits. You try to solve remaining bits if possible. Otherwise I'll explain in the next class. Thank you.